Hey, you guys, it's Peter, and I'm back. Of course I'm back. I'm not going anywhere. Beast. Demisha Iman. I'm YouTube famous now. Available in 2021, the album, Dad AF. Rock on, gold dust, woman. Beast. How are you guys doing today? No, this is not a rant video. Well, I don't know, maybe just a little bit. I always have things to rant about, so I'm sure that I have a couple things to rant about. I'm sitting in the parking lot of Walmart. I just went and got my, isn't my cup so pretty? My purple cup. I just went and got my coffee for the day. I'm getting ready to head up to the pool. Here's my pool bag. And I just went and did a review of the nacho fries from Taco Bell. Here, I'll show you. Nacho fries with the cheese that you get with those. Can I just tell you, here is actually a rant of mine for the day. Can we just talk about the fact that this little sip of a drink right here costs $1.89. $1.89 for this little sip of root beer right here. He handed it to me and I said, $1.89 is quite expensive for that. He goes, oh, and I said, this is on the video too, you can go see it. And I go, you don't think so? And he goes, I guess I'm just kind of indifferent to it. Anyway, let me tell you about my day, okay? Now, my plan had been to get up at 10 o'clock this morning and that I was going to film a bunch of videos and then I was gonna go to the pool, see, because it's super sunny outside. There's just some clouds. You can probably see them right there. It's 90 degrees, okay? And then tonight, my husband and I, we are going to Miss Indiana and Miss Teen Indiana USA pageant. I'm so excited because y'all know I love a good pageant, okay? And, by the way, National Entertainer of the Year, the finals were last night. Give a little congratulations. I think Paris Campbell won. Give a little congratulations to Paris Campbell. I believe she won last night. So anyway, I used to always go to the final night of National Entertainer of the Year in Louisville, Kentucky. I don't go anymore. But anyway, so I did that review today, and I was getting ready to go to the pool, and then after I got done with going to the pool, I was gonna go home and I was gonna film a drama video in my boring ASS chair, 25 cents in the cuss jar, and sit there, you know, and all that kind of stuff, and I thought, well, I should probably mix it up for just a day, you know, mix it up a little bit, and just kind of show you what it's really like when I'm driving around with my good Judy Tanya. So I thought, since I'm gonna show you what it's like, then I should have... Well, she's not here. Oh my God, did I fool you? You thought Tanya Jean was in the car and it was gonna be she and I talking about Jeffree Star. Girl, Tanya Jean don't care about Jeffree Star. No, but we do talk about all this kind of stuff. She'll always like, my good Judy Tanya Jean, she'll like, she didn't know who any of these people were before I started making the YouTubes, you know? And then now she'll get in the car and she'll say, did you see that Trisha Paytas is going to be on Tana Mojo's podcast? Did you see that? And I'll be like, yes, Tanya Jean. And then she'll say, well, what do you think? Oh, my God. She'll say, did you see that picture of Trisha Paytas? For some reason, she's always wanting to talk about Trisha Paytas. Did you see that Trisha Paytas, that picture that they put up on the Twitter? Oh, my Lord, for the OnlyFans. So Tanya's always saying all this kind of stuff to me about that. But then she'll say, oh, did you see Jeffree Star's new palette? What do you think about that? So anyway, I thought I would just kind of show you what a conversation like that is about, and I'll just give you my total thoughts, okay? What do I think about Jeffree Star's new palette, which is called Pink Religion? I think it is... Jeffree Star has run out of ways to be edgy, you know? And what's really interesting to me about this is that so many people are comparing this. Like, I've gotten so many comments and people have asked me to review the palette. Okay, girl. And talk about the palette, and they're like, oh, it's just like Madonna's back in the day when, like, the Catholic Church came for Madonna when she did, like, a prayer. I don't know if people remember or not, okay? But I do remember when the Catholic Church came for Madonna for, like, a prayer. That was at the towards the beginning of her career, okay? Not the end of her career. I'm just saying, okay? When you have run out of edgy ideas, and so your edgiest idea is to come for the Catholic Church, I think you've kind of run out of ideas, okay? I'm just saying, okay? It's not super edgy to me. You know, he's got these mirrors and stuff that look like crosses in the church and all that kind of stuff. And it's this whole pink theme. I went and I read the Beauty Guru Reddit. I read like every comment on there. And you guys, people that know 100 times more about makeup than I'll ever know, were just letting him have it about this palette. They're like, oh sure, all the pinks won't look the same. One of the things that a lot of people say about Jeffree Star's palettes is that the way he mixes it up is that it makes it look like he's got like all these different like color plays, but in reality, if you lined them up in, you know, like gradation of like lightest to darkest pink, that a lot of these pinks would lay the same on the eye, right? Like they wouldn't look that much different. And so anyway, people are going in on this palette, and it's interesting to me because I was like looking on the Twitter and people were like, oh my God, I love this palette so much. No, you're Jeffree Star stans, okay? You have to have this palette. Anyway, so there's the whole thing about Jeffree Star coming for the Catholic Church and him being so edgy and all this kind of stuff about this palette. Now, I will say I watched the video of the launch. I thought the video was done very beautifully. I'm not somebody that's offended by that stuff, just so you know. Like, to me, it's not edgy because I'm not offended by it. I'm not Catholic. I've never been Catholic. That kind of stuff don't offend me, okay? You know, I have a bunch of naked bodies all over crosses. I don't care. Do it, okay? But I did think that the video was shot beautifully. I thought the promo ads and all that kind of stuff were shot beautifully and all that kind of stuff. I just don't get that jazzed about anything that Jeffree Star puts out anymore. It's just the same thing over and over and over again. A palette, four mirrors, lip ammunition. I mean, it's just the same thing over and over and over again. And he don't even post videos anymore, okay? The only time he's ever posting a video is if he has something to sell. He don't want to be a YouTuber anymore. He don't care about it. All these people that he got to just like follow his gigs that he could sell his stuff, he don't care. He don't care about you. He don't care about YouTube anymore. None of these people do. And this is the thing that really just pisses me off so much, right? I love YouTube. I love everything about it. I love making videos. I love every day getting up and figuring out what I'm gonna do. I love trying to come up with, like, you know, last night I was like, people recommended to me, they're like, oh, you should do a video, because I was like, what should I do for my Peter Does Stuff channel? And I got like a couple people that said, oh, you should go night swimming, right? I was like, oh my God, I'll go night swimming. That'll be such a fun idea. So last night I wanted to make sure that I was like the last one at the pool so I could go night swimming and blah, 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 whatever. And I love everything about filming videos, right? And I feel so blessed that every single day I get to get up and I get to do something that I absolutely love. And that's because of you. That's because you guys watch my videos. And I just want to say, I really, really appreciate it, right? You're making this old man's dreams come true. So when I see these people that can't even post a video to save their life, I'm just so bored of it. I'm just so bored. I'm like, you don't want your platform, hand it to somebody else, okay? Say, Judy Smith, she wants it bad enough, so she's taking over the Jaclyn Hill, okay? Or she gonna be the new Jaclyn Hill or something. I don't know. It's just so sad to me. These people just don't even care about their own stuff anymore, you know? Oh, here it was. I was looking at Jeffree Star Cosmetics. Say hello to the Pink Religion Collection from our 18 pan Bible to the it's always 18 pans, and every one of his thing is 18 pans. To the mesmerizing Sacred Glass Extreme Frost Palette. This collection takes you on a beautiful journey of every pink hue imaginable. Now, is it just me, or has Jeffree Star been doing pink for a long time, okay? Do you remember when he came out and he had the all red palette? Because everybody needs an all red palette, right? You remember that? I don't know why people haven't figured this out yet, but basically what he does is he just picks the next color and then he makes this huge fiasco about it, okay? Blue blood, okay? The red, what was the red one? I don't know. Satan's Kiss. What was the red one? Why can't I think of it? Why can't I think of what the red one was? Damn it, Janet. Anyway. Here he is, and I think the photo shoot where he's got, it says she's arrived, watch the Pink Religion palette, and he's sitting here eating a strawberry cake or something like that. I don't even, am I supposed to get it? I mean, I don't understand it. What's the symbology of eating this cake? Is there some symbology, let him eat cake? Is that what it is or something like that? Okay, Marie Antoinette. I just don't get it. What's the red one? Why can't I remember what the red one is? Okay, here's the blue blood. And then the all green one was the money, honey, and blood money. Okay, and then, hold on a second. Where's the all red one? Why can't I not? The thirsty was the orange palette. Okay, this is what he does. He just picks a color and then that's what it is. It's the next, blood sugar. How could I ever have forgotten blood sugar, right? So this is what we do, okay? This is how, okay, just so y'all know, like James Patterson, I don't mean to ruin this for you, but James Patterson don't write his own books anymore, okay? James Patterson has a team of people that come out and they write his books for him. So what they do is they all sit in like a big boardroom and then they present an idea to him and he like goes, yes, no, 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 no. Okay, and then they assign a group of people that are gonna write it. If you go look at James Patterson's, do y'all know who James Patterson is? He always has like 6 books out on the bestseller list, okay? And then each one of his books is like 291 pages. And it's like the same amount of chapters. And each chapter is like 2 pages, okay? And that's the format for how James Patterson works. And it works for him, okay? People still buy his books. I think his books are boring as sin, quite frankly. And I used to love them, right? I used to love them back in the day of Kiss the Girls and Along Came a Spider and all that kind of stuff. But he sold out. Jeffree Star, I feel like he sold out, okay? And that's my opinion. And I can have one, okay? Because opinions are like, you know what? Everybody's got them. Eureka O'Hara said it on RuPaul's All-Stars. And I do love Eureka. She's my favorite. So anyway, you go, Eureka. But anyway, this is the format of Jeffree Star, okay? Let's pick a color. And then we're going to come up with a theme. You know, like, there's going to be an all-white palette that comes out, and he's going to call it White Wedding or something, and everybody's going to say he's stealing Billy Idol's idea, okay? It'll be something like that, right? So, you got to pick a color, okay? And then you got to pick a theme to go with that color. I don't think he even cares about the pans and the eyeshadows. I know y'all do, okay? I don't think he really cares that much about it. I think first it's the color, and then it's the theme, okay? So, what's the color? I'm looking around. Yellow? Have we done? Well, yeah. I mean, thirsty was kind of yellow orange. Okay. So let's just say like he's gonna do an all yellow palette. Okay. So let's do an all yellow palette. We sit there and we have this board meeting. We pay everybody a lot of money to sit around and do. Let's do a yellow palette. Okay. And then we got to come up with a real edgy theme. What's our theme? And then, you know, Sally Jo over there in the corner, she says, well, I think a really good theme for yellow is sunshine. And everybody looks at her like she's crazy because she forgot for a second that she worked for Jeffree Star Cosmetics. She didn't work for Pollyanna Makeup, you know. So then they look at her and they go, oh, no, thanks, Sally Jo. But can you go get me a Red Bull because we don't need any more of your ideas because they're stupid, you know. And then Cindy Lou Who over here, she says, well, yellow always reminds me of butterscotch. Why don't we do a butterscotch themed candy palette? And they all look at her like she's crazy, okay? And Jeffree Star says, I think we're gonna have Taco Bell for lunch. Cindy Lou Who, can you go get that for us? Because we don't need any more of your ideas, right? And then this gal over here in the corner, she goes, why don't we call it Pee on Me? And Jeffree Star goes, oh, that's genius. Pee on Me. The people go crazy. And we'll call one eyeshadow will be called Golden Showers. And then the other one will be called Bending Over. And then the other one will be called Toilet. Oh, I just can't believe it. It'll be so edgy. Everybody will have to have it. And then we'll have, we'll do a photo shoot. Well, Jeffree, what about the colors of the eyeshadow palette? We don't care about all that. Yellows. Just a bunch, figure it out. A bunch of yellows. I'll come up with the names. And the mirrors could all look like toilets. Okay. Now, the photo shoot, what we're going to do for the photo shoot is it's going to be me with a diverse collection of different men. Okay. All kinds of men from every different kind of background. It's going to be me, and I'm going to be in the middle. And I see myself in a pink wig and a something roll, and I'll be bending over and doing all kinds of this kind of stuff. And it'll be like these men, and it'll look like they're doing something. It'll be looking like they're peeing on me, but it'll really just be water fountains, okay? Water fountains of gold. And oh, my Lord. That's what we'll call it. The Golden Pee on Me palette. Oh my God, I just see it right now. $54 for 18 pans is we're gonna call it, and the mirrors are gonna look like toilets, so people eat it up and they'll have to have it. And then he'll put out a little bit of picture of something, you know, the people, oh my God, I gotta have a toilet mirror, I gotta have a toilet mirror, I don't have a toilet mirror. I'm so bored of this, okay? This is what people don't figure out about Jeffree Star. He's a lonely doll, he's a lonely doll. You don't have nobody to hang out with. Somebody over here on the Beauty Guru Reddit, they're like, I don't know, is it just me, or has Jeffree lost his way ever since the breakup a couple years ago, like creatively lost his way? I'm like, I don't think that's it. I really don't think that's it. I think that people forget that Jeffree Star has always banked on being super, super edgy, okay? Let's tell some truths for a second in this car, okay? This is where I rant. This is where I get real in this car, okay? Not that I don't do it in that chair, but that's a subdued version of me. People can't handle this shady version of Peter. When I'm like, they're like, oh my God, he's so shady. Every other drama channel in the world gets to be so shady boots, right? But the second that I'm shady, people are like, oh, I can't handle it. Peter's shady? Oh, no, 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 Peter. But let's just tell some truths for a second, okay? His music was never that good to begin with, okay? He caught on to the MySpace thing before anybody else did. And I did like some of his songs. I did back in the day. You know, Beauty Killer, I liked that song. I thought it was okay. It was catchy. It was edgy, you know? But whatever. But do I think that he's the next Joan Baez, you know? Or, I don't know, the next Beyonce? It's keyboard music that he uploaded to MySpace and he got on Warped Tour. Can we just call it for what it is? Okay, I know he got signed with like all these people and whatever. It's because he was the first. Like, he was a trendsetter. If Jeffree Star is anything, if I have to acknowledge anything and give him credit, he's a trendsetter. He is, okay? The problem is he doesn't have his finger on the pulse anymore because he's not 25 anymore, right? He's in his 30s. And so he's kind of running out of ideas right now. Hell, I could have come up with an edgier idea than this. You want to come out with an edgy idea in 2021 of what to do with a palette? Girl, I mean, there are so many things that you could have come up with to be edgy in 2021 that coming for the Catholic Church is like as deep as it goes. Or are you just trying to be the reinvented version of Madonna? Like, seriously? I mean, to me, it's I don't know. Jeffree Star has always been two steps ahead of the game. That is what has saved him. That is what's made his millions, okay? When he got on YouTube and he started this whole Jeffree Star approved thing and people followed him from the MySpace music over to saying the thing that people loved about him was that he used a lot of color in his makeup, that he was real edgy, he was real different. He made them feel good in their own skin. He made people feel good for being different and wanting to try things that are different and wanting to try things to be unique. And you know what? To that, I think that is amazing. I think that that's awesome that somebody can give that to somebody else, right? I love that. Y'all know I live by the motto of be too much, okay? But somewhere along the way, it stopped being about... what am I giving to the people? And it became about what are the people giving to me as far as money. It became about money, 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 money. And that's why we don't see consistent videos of Jeffree Star approved makeup. Even if the people didn't care, he still gets a lot of views on his videos, right? That's why we don't see videos about going to the Taco Bell hotel or, hey, just me hanging out and doing whatever with my good Judy's. We don't see those videos anymore because he doesn't care about YouTube anymore. Because he's gotten YouTube to a point where now he knows he has his stands that will buy his products, and that's all he has. Somebody is driving over. Paparazzi! And that's all that he needs, right? Like, I don't think he really cares that much anymore. And I don't think we're gonna see a bunch of Jeffree Star approved videos in the past. You know, back in the day, he posted quite a bit. He really did. And I think people really liked his Jeffree Star approved videos, and that was something new. People hadn't seen that before, right? Where it was like, if Jeffree Star doesn't approve it, it's not approved. And then people were excited about his makeup that had come from the music area. And then people that didn't know about his music were excited about him because, like, the number one thing... Seriously, this person is walking over here while I am trying to do a video. The number one thing that people say to me about Jeffree Star and his makeup, about why they originally liked it, was like, Jeffree Star was not afraid to use color in his makeups. And, you know, like, and blues and pinks and reds and all that kind of stuff. And that is something that he has always banked on. And now if you look at his palettes, they continue to do that, right? But it started to get mundane. It started to get repetitive. I said in a video not too long ago, I said every one of Jeffree Star palettes releases looked almost identical to me. And somebody like was like, oh, that's not true, blah, 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 whatever. And then I went over and I read the Beauty Guru Reddit, like I said, of people that know a lot more about this than I do. And there were so many comments over there that people were like, his makeup all looks the same. I mean, you guys should go over here and read the comments that are on this. They're like, oh, it all looks the same. My God, Jeffree puts more effort into picking the names of his palettes over the actual palettes. Any excuse to put out an encrusted a crucifix, I guess. Someone said, I really dislike large monochrome palettes. They feel so redundant and dull. If you're going to do monochrome, do an edited down, smaller palette. Put some thought and artistic vision into it. Well, not you, Jeffree. Redundant and dull suits you. Continue your slide into obscurity. Okay, and it goes on and on and on. Just as I thought, it's an oversized, and they talk about, they compare it so much over here to ColourPop monochromatic palette. I'm not his fan, but can't he come out with an actual color story? Who needs so much of the same shade? It's the same boring one color theme in every launch. If you go to the top, people are like, you couldn't. Okay, wait. Someone said, I'm kind of forgetting his makeup exists nowadays. Don't really hear much about it, and I don't think his launches break the internet anymore. This palette might as well be a makeup revolution palette, nothing special. And someone said, I have ColourPop pink palettes that have more variety and texture and were cheaper. People go on to talk about, where is the one that says, half of those pinks will look the same on the eye. Jeffree's honestly has a terrible eye for color. I don't know where he got the reputation of being an amazing visionary for eyeshadow color stories. Someone that said, I think it helps that he never does his own makeup for promos. The launch videos on YouTube, Lipstick Nick would do so his eyes look good. She would work with his palettes and make it look amazing. It forced you to believe his makeup was wearable and inspiring. The looks he did in his own videos were weird and didn't make sense. Someone said, he never does his own makeup for promos. I don't think he does his own makeup on the regular, full stop. I'm pretty sure there was a vacation back in the day that he brought Lipstick Nick. Well, that's one of the things that he's been criticized for through the years. It's like, you know, Nikki Tutorials has talked about this. She always does her own makeup, whether she's doing a red carpet event or anything else. And all these other people have like makeup artists that do their stuff. Now, I have said in the past, and I have learned my lesson, and I've taken the critique, when I said, I don't understand why as a makeup artist you wouldn't do your own makeup, whatever it was for. And a lot of people said to me, well, even if it's for like something that it's red carpet, then yes, you would get a makeup artist for that. Okay, I agree with that. I think that's a fair statement. But on the daily, I mean, this is the other thing that kills me in all honesty, is that I think makeup got a majority of these people to where they're at on YouTube and selling makeup, but I just don't really think that they're that excited about doing makeup anymore. I just really don't, okay? I mean, they don't even like, okay, first of all, if you look at the majority of these people, most of them don't even, if you go watch their Instagram stories, and I do, and I'm talking about, you pick out YouTubers across the board, okay? James Charles, he's not in makeup unless he does a makeup look, okay? Or he's going to some event. Jeffree Star, he's never in makeup hanging around his house, okay? Unless he's doing a promo video or whatever. Otherwise, it's hair. When his hair was longer, it's hair back and in a robe, okay? You know, Manny in UA, he does makeup when he's going to do something or shooting a video. Laura Lee, it's the same thing. Jaclyn Hill, she hardly ever puts on makeup sitting around the house. These people don't really care about makeup anymore, you know? And hey, listen, just because that's their job doesn't mean that they have to, like, do it 24 hours a day. But, like, are you not interested in makeup anymore? Because that's what you sold to everybody else, was that you were really, you love to play with makeup, you're interested in makeup and whatever. And in all honesty, the two people that I see that probably wear makeup the most, well, I guess, okay. James Charles, like, kind of, once he gets up for the day, he's, like, he's got his makeup on, he's ready to go. I don't see that with Jeffree Star. Manny MUA, he kind of, he'll go to the gym and whatever, and he's, you know, all scruffy and all that kind of stuff, but then when he's doing a video or whatever, he's in his makeup. Laura Lee, she kind of has her makeup on more regularly, I'd say. Jaclyn Hill, she don't never have no makeup on, okay? She just hair up in a scrunchie and whatever. Or maybe she just doesn't care about it anymore. I don't know. Anyway. That's what I think about all that. This is my rant for the day. Not really. Are you going to buy Jeffree Star's new palette? I don't even know when it comes out. When does it come out? I mean, I should know because I just watched. Hold on a second. I just watched the video. This video when it came out. Hold on a second. Here it is. Okay. Please forgive me. Like, please forgive our sins kind of thing. Our iconic pink religion palette collection launch this Friday. We can't wait for everyone to dive into every hue of pink imaginable. Look at that hairdo. Hair by Jay did that. Oh, and he's like, okay. Anyway, he's in a confessional. How shocking. How shocking. I bet hearing a confession from Jeffree Star would be about as boring as this palette is. Anyway, let me know what you think in the comment section below. I love you guys, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.